Good evening. First of all, thank you for coming. That first piece was Overture for Winds by Charles Carter, kind of one of those staples, no pun intended with the auditorium, staples of the wind band literature, written in the late 50s by Charles Carter. The second piece we are going to do tonight was actually a commission composed by my wonderful wife, who unfortunately couldn't be here tonight with us, but written by Carly Galladay. The piece is titled Salute. This is an excerpt from the program notes. Nestled in the Green Mountains of Vermont lies America's oldest private military college, Norwich University. The sun goes away in October, and after a regal display of colorful trees, the gray and snowy days arrive, and then the sun rises again in May. The views and colors are breathtaking and really pretty when the sun peeks out after fresh fallen snow. Salute was commissioned by Lieutenant Colonel Todd Edwards of Norwich University for their bicentennial celebration and had its premier performance at Carnegie Hall in March of 2020. Here is Salute by Carly Galladay.
Thank you.
The next piece this evening is Hymn to a Blue Hour by composer John Mackey. He writes, "The blue hour is an oft-poeticized moment of the day, a lingering twilight that halos the sky after sundown, but before complete darkness sets in. It is a time of day known for its romantic, spiritual, and ethereal connotations, and this magical moment has frequently inspired artists to attempt to capture its remarkable essence. This is the same essence that inhabits the sonic world of our next selection. We hope you enjoy John Mackey's Hymn to a Blue Hour."
Thank you.
Again, that was Hymn to a Blue Hour by John Mackey. The next composition we are going to perform is entitled The Greatest Generation by Julie Giroux. Composed to honor those who both endured and contributed so much to society, this work goes from grandeur to swing, capturing the essence of the 1940s. The work pays homage to those who did not return from World War II, with a slow, expressive section, which features Hendrix professor Dr. Krebs this evening on piano. It concludes with a vibrant finale that once again features lively jazz rhythms and seems to indicate the work and prosperity that this generation gave to our nation. This was actually a composition that was commissioned for somebody's late father who served in World War II. And composed by Julie Giroux after they met at the Midwest Conference in Chicago, Illinois. Here is The Greatest Generation by Julie Giroux.
Thank you.
Thank you again to Dr. Krebs for joining us tonight on piano. We really appreciate that. Thank you. Final selection this evening is entitled The Witch and the Saint by Stephen Reinecke. This is what he writes about the piece. The Witch and the Saint is a programmatic tone poem for symphonic band in one movement that is constructed in five distinct sections to tell the story of the lives of two sisters, Helena and Sibylla, twin sisters born in Germany in 1588. Starting out with a Gregorian chant-type motif, Reinecke uses all manner of musical sorcery to represent the turbulent lives of these vastly misunderstood women. Here is The Witch and the Saint by Stephen Reinecke.
Thank you.
Thank you again so much for coming this evening. We hope you enjoyed the concert. We have another one outside on April 17th. It's a Monday evening, so please plan on joining us then. And thank you once again.